In this subtitle editor tutorial, I'll show you how you can automatically translate your subtitles to different languages. Now, welcome to this video. My name is David and I hope you're well wherever you are around the world. So let's begin by adding in our video. Just add our video. And if you have subtitles, you can actually just add them. But I'm going to go the old school way or the new school way and automatically transcribe this particular video. Go to video. Audio to text, and then if you installed all these models, then choose the model you want to use, and this is in English, so I'll just click on generate. So it's loading, it's transcribing the audio to text, gives you the time remaining for this to be done. Really awesome. But now the reason why you may need to do the automatic translate is maybe you want to save time when it comes to translations. It may not be the best translation because it's going to be using Google and all that, but probably can save you time and maybe you can be busy doing other things. Now, let's give this time, but you can also get Google APIs, DeepL APIs. I believe they're paid for you to use and get better results and faster results when you use them. So that's an option that you can actually work with so that you can speed your process of auto translation in subtitle edit. Now this is almost done, and our automatic transcription and subtitling has been done. Looks good. If we play it slightly.
With the recent update on the YouTube interface, it's now easier than before to download YouTube transcripts.
Looks good. Sounds good. ADC. So now, if you're satisfied with this, now let's translate our subtitles. Click on auto translate. And from this section, you'll see a couple of different options. For these two options down here, I've had to download the plugins for this, but since I don't have the API keys for this, then it's not possible for you to use this now. Let's click on auto translate or control shift G. And this is going to use the Google Translate version 1 API. And you'll see this here. And what language do you want to translate from English to each other language? Let's say we want to do maybe something like Spanish. I don't know Spanish, but I'm assuming that is going to give me a Google Translate kind of translation of this. So let's click on translate. Please note, trying to translate without API key is slow and has limited data. You are to use an API key, go to options, settings, tools, and enter your Google Translate API key. So that's okay. Click OK. And since this is not a big file, it's already done. So we can come up here. I just want to say maybe this may be the only thing I might know here. Hola, mi nombre es David. So hi, my name is David. So I think it's done a good job per se based on that we're using the auto translate feature. Now, you can do a couple of things. You can merge max two lines, merge sentences, no merging, etc. But let's assume you're satisfied. Click OK. Now, here you'll see one column right here is going to have your text, the translated, and then we'll have the original text right here. So we can play this video.
With the recent update on the YouTube.
Now, what you'll see the translated version here.
Yes. It's now easier than before.
You can make the edits based on what you see. So once you're satisfied, you can come to file and then click on save as to save the translated. And you'll see that automatically subtitle edit, we include the .es or the Spanish extension. So you can do that and call it one or auto translate and click on save. And we're going to save as a subrip. Or an SRT, just click on save. So that's done. And then remember, you need to save your original. If there are no changes, just click on file, save original subtitle. And then you can just add whatever you want here. Just click on save. And now it is saved. But that is how you can simply and automatically translate subtitles from language to another inside Subtitle Edit. You'd have better results if you had a Google API key. It would speed up the process and give you better results. If you also have DeepL API keys, that would also be another option, because you'll just go to here, actually go to file, go to plugins, and then get plugins, and then get the DeepL Pro Translate plugin. And once it's installed, you can come to Auto Translate, translate with DeepL, and then if you have the API key, just pop it inside here, and you're good to go. So that's it from me. Until next time, stay safe and never stop learning. Thanks for watching.